morning to all of you. Now we are going to see the broadcast receiver. Now first we will see what is the broadcast receiver is. Whenever the notification comes or the alert messages comes, that is known as broadcast receiver. Internally it is going to use a thread. So by using a thread you can check after a particular time interval what the broadcast has come or not. So that is called as broadcast receiver. So we have taken one example for the broadcast receiver. That is the alarm message we have taken. So for suppose I want to use a particular time, and on that particular time the alarm should on, or that is called as a broadcast. Or if the any notification comes or any alert message comes, that is called as broadcast receiver. So simply we have taken two controls, one that is a button control and one that is a text box. So this will be the text box and the button. When I click on the button, that the broadcast receiver is going to occur. So we have taken button, and the value of the button is start, that is the object name is start. So I have taken the layout initialization, that is set content view r.layout.activity_broadcast, and start is going to find view by id r.id.button. Now when you click on the button, that is I'm using set on click listener. So in interface I'm using that on click listener, and the method implement is on click. So this is already we have seen how we are going to call the events on a button click. Now when I click on the button, I'm going to call the start method. Now the start method is written over here. As the start method is, the start method is inside the class, so it should be a private. So I have written a start method. Now here we have taken the edit text for the time. Now this is the integer I, and I'm getting the text for this one. Now intent is equal to intent, this that is current, and my broadcast receiver dot class. So here I'm calling the broadcast receiver. Okay, so this broadcast receiver is going to occur. Now the pending intent is equal to object is equal to get broadcast. Now here we have written some code, that is this dot application context means the current screen, and this is the default value for the request code, it comes automatic, and this is the intent is nothing but this the object intent. Now the alarm manager, that is a class, this class is present in the android.app.alarmManager. So this class should be imported first, android.app. So alarm manager alarm is equal to alarm manager get system service alarm service. So get system service, it is a method we have called. So get system service and alarm service. So alarm manager dot set is equal to alarm manager dot RTC wake up. So it is going to wake up, and after that system dot current time in milliseconds. So into one. So this is logic we applied. So the alarm is set on this time interval. So this will be the toast message it is going to occur. So this was a very simple example for the broadcast receiver. We have taken one example for the alarm only. Now suppose I want to call this, I can set the file name over here. The file name should be my broadcast receiver. Now when you run a program, now after this running the program, the output will be like this. Here we have to give the value for the alarm, and when you click on this, the alarm will be start. Now this is emulator. So for the emulator, this is the constant, means the values are constant. So you can take the APK file of this and you can check out, it will be start, it will start. Now second thing, that whenever you want to make the entry of means whenever you create the broadcast receiver, you have to make the entry in the Android manifest file. So in the provider tag, you have to provide the receiver name. So receiver and Android name is equal to dot my broadcast receiver. This is the class name. So we have to make the entry of this receiver also. So this is very important. So whenever you make the entry of this, means whenever you create any broadcast receiver, there must be entry in the Android manifest file. Second thing, we have to import the class that is broadcast receiver. So this was the code for creating or for executing the broadcast. So broadcast, there is also proximity alert also. So there is a different proximity alerts which we can use for a different kind of notifications. This is one kind of notification. So when we set the time at a particular time interval, the pop-up will occur. That means the alarm is set on this will be the printed, and once it is set at the current time, means at the given time interval, the alarm is going to buzzer. So this was the code for the broadcast receiver. If you have any doubts, any question, you can put on the comments. Thank you.